A cow. I'm like chewing.
Oh, I gotta. I'll eat you with you. Muffins.
Mm-hmm. So delicious. Mm-hmm. Homemade blueberry muffins to die for. They're really good. They're fantastic.
You're too kind.
I like the sugar on the top.
Well, I did she that as a lifesaver because it was so good. It's not that good. These are actually awful. Mm-hmm. I made them this morning knowing that you were coming over. Mm. Oh, we should say good morning first.
Mm. Good morning.
Good morning. It's been so long since we've been together, since before Christmas. Mm-hmm. And, and I have a Christmas present for you.
You have not even been here. I have one for you, too, but I didn't wrap it.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, my goodness.
You're going to laugh after you open this.
Okay, well, you have to pick what you want, because I was like, I don't want to give you something that you're not, like, you have to have, like, color-wise. Mm-hmm. So, you can pick.
Well, I want. You're going to laugh after you
told me.
Really?
It's not. Okay.
But it sort of is.
Oh my gosh.
But it's 365 days of wonder.
Oh. Wow.
So talk about why I gave that to you.
This is so good. So hold on a sec. This, over Christmas, I read my kids this book. And it's amazing. They devoured it. They loved it completely. But I told my doctor about it. So the next one that comes, Augie and Me, is apparently the writer has a little bit of a surprise, like not so good kind of thing. I wouldn't recommend
the
Augie and Me, because she actually brings up apparently the Holocaust. Mm. And it took my doctor, oh my goodness, the week to like recalibrate his child.
How old
because
was the
she
child?
Was traumatized. She's the same age as my son, so she's 9 years old, and it was not
maybe
not
for cool. An older child.
She did, yeah, maybe like I don't know, someone, yeah,
because they deal with that in school.
So, this was really, really good. And oh my gosh, this is awesome!
So, I bought that at we had a book fair at school, and I saw it. Every day there's a little reading,
yeah. I actually wrote down a bunch of Mr. Brown's precepts and used it in my English essay.
There you go.
And got an A+.
Well, there you go.
Yay!
So talk about your school!
Oh, well, I finished my last two upgrade courses. It was crazy because I got demoted. I had done first year science at U of C, and so then I had to go back and redo my English 30 and Bio 30, which just was like, oh, you're kidding me. But I'm glad I did, because it had been, oh my goodness, like 20 years since I've done Bio 30. Mm-hmm. And I needed to know, I needed to refresh. Like, I forgot a lot of the stuff.
So they do it for a reason, that saying.
They do. Mm-hmm. It was really good that I did it. And
talk about why you're doing all this.
I upgraded. And so I'm doing it to get into the respiratory therapy program. And so I'm in selection right now for the program. And the hardest part for me sometimes is the waiting, right? Mm-hmm. So I'm just waiting to see if I
can. So you're knitting your stress relief.
I'm knitting like full time.
So you did school till Christmas.
I did school.
And stressed right out. And then come Christmas, it was like, oh, and now you're all the crafts, all the knitting all the time.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
It's great. And the funny thing is, when I started dyeing yarn about like a year and a half ago now, like full time, and I did my website, YYC Knits. I never had a chance to knit with my own yarn.
Oh.
So I was like, I had all this beautiful yarn and I've never run my fingers
and
through it.
And you should, because it's so lovely to
you
work
know,
with.
I've
wearing.
Gifted a lot of it, which
if
is,
you can see,
yeah.
I think it should be
fuller down a little? We could, because there's a lot of sky in there.
There's a lot of sky and stuff. Okay, I'm going to... Anyway, before we move on to the next section, let's talk about who we are.
And, oh my goodness, and you...
I'm Knit-Nix. I'm Carla Jean on Instagram, and I'm Knit-Nix on Ravelry, and this is the Knit-Nix podcast, and Leslie's been here a lot. So this is our... How many times have we done this together? Is this...
Like one, four?
This is number four. I think we did. Our first one was you're dying at your place.
Yeah.
Then you got lost in the sofa over there.
Yeah, sucked into the couch. Yeah.
Okay, and then we did one here.
We did the soft blank one.
And four. This is five. This is
number five.
Right.
And I love doing this with you.
Yeah.
It's so awesome. We got our beautiful mugs.
Yes, we do.
That Carla gifted to me.
From Chasing Fire
Studios.
Yeah. And we both
on Instagram.
So yum. Cheers.
And I'm just YYC Knits on everything. So.
You're an indie dyer, and you're a pattern designer, and a mom, and
and a student.
And a student.
A jack of all trades.
You wear many
master
hats.
Master of none. I know.
I have to learn to sit back and relax.
Yeah,
so yes, totally. I wanted to brag about this again. This is my go-to little shawlette.
I love that.
It's a real easy pattern. It's a freebie on Ravelry. It's called Simple Shawl. And I'll put the designer. But Indy Dyer was this girl, and it's lovely, and she was just noticing how well it goes with the hair.
Yeah, that color came out of my pot, and once it dried, I was like, oh, that's Carla Jean's. I call you Carla Jean all the time.
That's because that's how you see me on Instagram.
My mom and dad just love you, hey?
They're really?
Like, my dad is like, he's like, where's your, what's he call it, a gidget or a widget? Where's your widget? He comes over, he's like, how do I get on Google? He's 79. And he's like,
uh-oh.
How do I get on Google?
79-year-old
so then, yeah, he stalks you on Instagram. I'm like, what are you doing? Oh, look at her socks. The socks that you held up and says, if you can read this, I need wine or whatever. And he's like, this girl's hilarious. He loves you. Mm-hmm. My mom and dad both love you.
Well, I should meet them.
You should. I know.
Yeah. For sure. Yeah. Anyway, let's move on.
Yeah.
So you were talking about the book. That's good. Your hat. Tell us about your hat.
I have to write this up still. I designed this out of the Rodney sheep. It's kind of a long story. I started knitting in stillness out of this BFL, this really beautiful BFL, but too small a needle, wasn't working, so I fudged it. I still have to rip it apart, but I just
love your hat.
Whipped up the hat.
And what is the pattern?
It is my pattern, my design. I'm not going to say the name because it has not been taken yet and it's a surprise.
Okay. So it's your new design that's going to be put to print soon.
Yeah. Soon. Okay. I have to just write up the PDF and get it on there.
It's such a lot of work. It's cabling.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's got, just the diamond on the top. It's kind of a fish too, I noticed.
Oh.
Because I couldn't get two full diamonds or it would have been huge. And then it's just got the cable and
so you could wear it different ways. You could put it if you decided.
Oh, you could wear it like
this, I like that too.
You know?
That's
with
cool.
The diamond in the back.
I love that.
It's just like I love it.
Yeah, it's fun.
Yeah, it's really fun. So and then I did up this heterozygous hat with a little bit of a rolled this is out of my 12 Mile Cooley Park base. Mm-hmm. All of our yarns are named after Calgary Park, if you don't already know. And yeah, so this is called the heterozygous hat because it kind of goes both ways. It's like I put it on my husband's head and it looks really good on him too.
Oh.
So it can be...
I like hats that are a thinner, like this, I have a big head and add this to my big head.
You look great in hats. That picture that your daughter took was amazing.
That was with this hat. And let's talk about my hat.
Oh, yes.
This is my hat. Oh. Well, actually, the hat that was in the picture was gifted to my vice principal.
Oh.
Because she's really flexible and allows me to switch my days and stuff.
Yeah,
and I love her.
Oh, my
gosh. And I'm going to insert a picture of that here. Her in that hat, and I'll also insert a picture of me in that hat right now. But same pattern, different yarn.
And you designed this pattern?
This is mine. Oh,
this is your own. Are you going to post it?
I don't know. But anyway,
it's gorgeous.
It's a really simple little hat, and this is made out of, and I've never knit with it before, Angora. No. What's the other one that looks like a llama? Alpaca.
Alpaca.
This is alpaca. Isn't it awesome? It's soft.
And I know.
And then,
what this
okay,
is.
There's a story with this.
Okay.
I bought this online and I bought it, had them delivered to California. And this little, I took it to, I have a knitting class at school and I took it to school and I showed the kids and a little girl goes, did a rabbit have to die for that? And I'm like, oh my goodness. I said, you know what? I think that this is the, somebody ate the rabbit. And we wanted to use all of the parts of the rabbit.
Yeah, that
so
would be good.
That's how I explained it. I've been told since that possibly that's not the case.
No.
That they just actually raised rabbits for this purpose, which makes me sad. But anyway, it's
raising
beautiful.
Raising them for meat, too. I mean, hopefully they use the whole rabbit, you know.
Exactly. But anyway, but I explained to her that and all of a sudden she could, I don't know if it's true, but sometimes it's nice to soften.
Soften the blow. Yeah. Especially when they have a pet bunny at home, mine, like we do. Right?
Sorry. It's so, but don't you have some of these?
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Yeah,
so,
I
anyway,
do.
So that's it. Yeah. And yeah, I enjoyed making it. And this one is
beautiful.
To be determined, but I think it's probably for my daughter.
It's gorgeous. Yeah.
And it's cables. I think there's five cables. Five cable repeat.
Wow. Yeah, so I love it. I would put it up there.
Do you think so?
Get it out there. Put the PDF up.
Yeah, I might.
So I've been doing a lot of tests through my group, YYC Knits on Ravelry, and I am just blown away by all the amazing knitters out there. And Lesley, if you're watching, she has the same name as me, same spelling, everything.
I love you.
She's such a doll, and she's going through some terrible time right now with flooding in California. So I have been able to meet like the coolest knitters. This hat, the heterozygous hat, then I popped up a PDF of these mitts. The thumbs still need some work, but these are the recombination mittens. And some girl who's a scientist is like, the scientist in me just loves the name of your mittens because they're to do with cellular reproduction. Hello, every scientist loves that. And she's like from, just all over the world. Like I don't remember exactly where she was from, but it's so amazing. Mm-hmm. The community on Ravelry. I'm so overwhelmed by the goodness. And I actually just finished, we're still testing this. This is the Busy Bee hat. So we're still testing this and I sent a bunch of yarn out for whoever wanted to knit this, my own hand-dyed yarn. So they were really happy to have that. And I just thought, gosh, all the work that these test knitters do, it's the least that I can do.
So it was the decreases that you were struggling with a little bit?
Yeah, just to get them right and to get it
looks
to look
good, though.
Perfect.
Yeah,
so,
but it looks really good.
So
I think I
got it. And yeah, it turned out really, really cute. So it's cute on. It looks better on my kids than it does on me. It's not so... But, you know,
I like it.
Yeah, it's cute. So I just wanted to play around with the honeycomb cable. And this is actually a signature of the Erin knitters who would knit this cable. It signifies the hard work, the hardworking men who would go out to sea.
Oh,
and this is because
busy bees,
right? Because they work so hard. And
is it a difficult cable to do?
Honeycomb cable signifies that. It's not. It's super easy. It's just a 4 repeat, and you do a cable every 4 repeats.
Cool. So do you have any other finished objects?
One more hat.
One more. Oh, look at you. You know what? You wear hat.
I am a hat.
Yeah.
I'm a hat knitter.
You are.
So all these ideas just were in my head while I was in school, and I could not knit a thing. So this
is
a hat. They're 3 little bunnies.
Oh.
They're bobble butt bunnies because they have a little bobble for their tail. And my daughter wanted a hat and she wanted bunnies on her hat. And this is
really cute. I love the colors. I absolutely love how the purple and that.
So this is the collaboration I have with Malabrigo. This is how the inside turned out.
Wow.
It's pretty cool. Actually, I really like the brioche on the bottom inside out if you do it like with that instead.
Nice.
But I... did it like this. And then there's just some flowers with some baubles at the top. So they're all different heights. And then, the bunnies. And so then this was supposed to be like a starry night sky, mm-hmm. but where the rabbits ended, I didn't get to do enough black to really make it look like starry night, but it's okay.
Cute. It's really cute.
It turned out good.
And is the purple, is it like a, some kind of a
this
variegation?
Is Malabrigo.
Oh, okay.
That's Malabrigo, and that's my collaboration with them for this design, this is my Riley Park, the green. I actually turned into a real yarn snob. I started knitting this with Patton's Classic in this same kind of dark, limey green colorway. The colors are really good on your camera. And I couldn't knit with it. I was like, this does not, the butter does not go with the cardboard very well. It was like, it's too extreme, right?
Snob.
And when you're knitting with color work and you're doing one in one finger and one in the other, it's like, oh, I can't, one is totally beautiful butter and one is not. So anyways, those are hats.
So I'm trying to think if I have it. Oh, I have one more. I have another FO. What's off the sticks? We jumped right in, didn't we?
Oh my gosh, we did. We totally did.
You know the story on these.
Yes, I do.
We dyed these at your place.
Yeah,
they're
amazing.
In that episode. And these are my on the plane. No,
socks on a plane.
Socks on a plane.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. It's like sex in a pan. Do you remember that?
Yes.
That's like, that takes us back, hey?
Yeah, but I don't think socks on a plane is quite... I'd rather have sex on a plane. How about that?
Yeah, that would be very interesting. As I'm like turning five shades of red.
What do they call it? The Mile High Club?
Yeah.
No, these are my Mile High Club socks.
Yes.
No, they actually are called... See, they have a little cable in them. Let me bring that up there. And these are the, this is
really
the sock
pretty.
Blank socks that we did. And then the heel was
we
not really
good. We dyed the sock blanks in episode 19
or whatever.
21.
What are we on today?
I don't know.
We'll put it down here.
Yeah. And we dyed the sock blanks, so you can check out that.
And these were hanging in my tree.
Episode. Yeah, I did. I scaled her fence. The night before she was leaving, and it was so funny. You should, like, I should read the, I should, like, screenshot the conversation. It was hilarious. She's outside trying to find the skeins where I hid them in the dark, because I think it was 10:30.
I had three skeins.
It was 10:30 at night. I'm like, did you find your skeins?
And I'm going, what? Pardon me? And it was dark out, and it was cold. And it was, and it was a red one, a green one, and a teal one.
And a teal one.
Yeah.
Yeah, because she wanted to do the toes and heels in contrasting colors.
That I can do some helix with or something.
So
anyway,
so
they're finished. They're great.
They turned out amazing.
I
can't believe it.
The only thing I don't really like is with that pattern, the heel was a little different. So,
it's just a chunk, right?
Yeah, it's fine.
That's how mine turned out.
Yeah,
because of the way I worked my
heel. I wish it would have been more squared off.
Yeah,
like here.
How do you do? How would that work?
Because you're knitting across here.
Yeah,
you can't.
So
otherwise,
any pattern could you? Have you done contrasting heels before?
With a heel flap and a heel turn. That's what you do in the contrasting color. And with a, what do you call it, an afterthought heel, you can do it.
Okay.
And the fish kiss lips heel, you can do it.
Okay.
And,
okay.
And yeah,
because mine is the same because of the way I worked mine.
So my happy, Rotella, happy.
Yeah. Oh my happy, gosh. Happy. I wish I could show mine off. I could not get them off of my daughter.
Oh.
They were actually supposed to be for my son. So he's pretty upset that he's got a fat foot and they do not fit him. He tried so bad, like three times squishing them on. He's like, no. And he finally gave up and said, okay, Abby, you can have them. So Abby has them, my youngest.
Do you have a picture of them?
I do. And I can send it to you.
And we'll put it in here. So yours
they're so awesome.
Yeah.
They're amazing. I just updated my Ravelry, so you can check them out on there as well. And I just wigged the pattern too, so I might post it just as a sock pattern.
Cool. Oh, you didn't use this
and
pattern?
I love...
Or
no,
used part
I didn't.
Of it?
None of it.
Because you started it
I
that
did
way.
A candy cane stripe. Like, I just did a simple knit purl for here. And it's just, it looks very similar.
Oh, okay.
I love that cable.
Yes,
that is
it's
unreal.
An easy
it's
one,
gorgeous.
Too. Yeah, that's the same cable that's in my hat.
A major design.
That's my only cable I've ever done.
Kind of gets lost in the hat, you know.
And my sister said that she didn't use this pattern because she thought the cable in your shoe would feel funny, but it doesn't. It doesn't bother me at all.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it would be fine.
Yeah.
I love how you did the cuff. It is just the perfect amount. Like, it's really awesome.
Thanks.
Squishy.
So that's my socks that I finished. Did I finish anything else? Oh, I did this. This is finished. Let's talk about this. What is this?
Helix.
Yeah.
Maybe.
This is so my first. This is Helix. And I still have to do a pom-pom and I haven't decided what to do yet. So really this is, let's move into what's on the sticks.
Okay.
Because this is, it's off the sticks. But it's sort of on the stick still because I haven't done
it. It's not done.
And
I brought my pom pom maker.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, I did.
It's a big guy.
Pom pom, so we can like.
The only thing is I can't right now because unless I find the other ball of this yarn, because I'm using the rest of it in my mittens. But anyway,
a little bit.
This design is again my own. All it is just. It's easy, right? It's just you just find the right amount of stitches.
It's
and it's a three color helix. Explain what a helix is. It's a spiral, right?
Because when you're knitting in the round, you're knitting an actual spiral. So
yeah, there's no joins.
You want to take your, like, the only where you see it, the only place that you see it is right at the beginning, and that's where you start your color. Mm-hmm. So if you have, how many colors are you using?
Three.
Three colors. Mm-hmm. So you would divide your stitches in three. So say you have 60 stitches on your needles. Mm-hmm. You would take 20, 20, 20. Mm-hmm. So you'd knit 20 stitches, 20 stitches, and 20 stitches.
Of the three different colors.
Of the three different colors. Mm-hmm. Three different colors.
Let's
get that straight. Maybe I need some more coffee. Oh my gosh. And so then when you come around to your second color, you actually have to knit for twice as long.
Yes, exactly. And then it's always turning, right?
Yeah. So when you come to your next color, you drop that yarn.
Don't twist it.
Do not twist it in the back.
Yeah.
You drop it where it lays and you pick up the next color right next to it on the left side of it.
And keep knitting
and
with that one. And don't pull it tight.
Yeah.
Did you learn that too?
Yeah, it's
because if you pull it tight, it doesn't flow.
It cinches it up. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So the cool thing is when you turn that hat around, there's no beginning and no end to the
I like it because
to the stripes.
I'm a huge scrap knitter. I love using up my stash and using
bits.
So this is three little bits. This is leftover from my blue hat that I just showed you.
Mm-hmm.
My gray hat that I had the picture of. And this cream, which I had a skein of, and I just used that as my base, and then I just kept on with the cream and added the gray and the blue, and I didn't have much. I maybe had 20 grams.
Oh, wow.
Or
of
maybe
each color?
Of each color, and then, except for the white
or
the cream.
And I love that hat. It is so good.
It is good.
Like, I love
it's big, but I have a big bean. I have a big bean.
I love it. It's
cozy.
So
and then you
cute.
Can also fold it if you want. You have a choice.
You can roll it up.
You can roll it. And if that way, if you put a... You can do that too. And I like that too because it's extra warm, right?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Cute, eh?
Yeah, I like it a lot. It's going to be so good with the pom-pom.
I'm going to put a pom-pom. I was going to put this one on or one like this. And I've got some more coming. That would be cute, wouldn't it? But,
I bought these just to show you, these clover, and I got them at Michael's, and I tried to use a 50%, but they wouldn't let me for some reason.
Why?
I don't know if
was
they were
already
on sale.
Probably.
I don't know. Mm-hmm. But this, it makes the best pom-poms in the world. So my kids,
is that the big one? Oh, there's the big one.
My kids are crazy about it.
Look at this.
They have been making pom-poms, and I want to make a wreath for my front door. I want to update my wreath. So I updated my, this hat. What's it called? Please help me.
Oh, it's the bobble hat.
And it had a ridiculous tiny little pom-pom. And every time my son wore it, I was just like, oh, I couldn't stand it. So yeah,
I'm going to have to have a lesson on that one. Because I have
amazing.
I don't know which one I have, but it's a teeny tiny pink.
I had those too.
It doesn't work so well.
Yeah, I never used them. Because I was like, how does this work?
Exactly.
Right? And the funny thing when you told me you were knitting helix, I was like, that's funny. Great minds think alike, because I had cast on these socks. And they are being knit in a helix. You can see where I started. And so the next time I start, I won't I will be mindful. I will, I think, knit halfway across so that I start on the side.
Oh, okay.
So you just have to be mindful of where you
start. Is that two color then?
It's three color.
Wow, I love the colors.
These are actually...
Are those minis?
I'm going to write this up. And these are my MCN minis on my Carburn Park base. They are squishy delishy. So I dyed... Actually, that color is really good in the... camera. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I dyed mm-hmm. a red and then I left a natural. I left a natural.
Nice.
So these are actually...
Those are your minis?
Those are my minis.
So that's a full mini? One full mini?
That's a full mini.
So two full... Three full minis makes a pair of socks.
Probably.
It will.
I'm
because
not sure.
How many grams are these? You don't know.
Mm-hmm. We'd have to weigh them.
I can.
Yeah,
because
I can't remember what
I can
did.
Do a pair of socks out of about 75 to 80 grams.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
So I'm sure you're going to have enough.
Hmm. Okay.
And I'm doing the same darn thing as her.
I know.
It was
so
funny.
And we didn't even talk about
this. No, we
this
didn't.
Because you haven't even been here.
No, I know. I've
yeah,
been away.
You've been gone. We'll talk
anyway,
about that.
Anyway, so this, I'm doing the same thing. And my yarn that I'm using is from when we overdyed.
Oh, my goodness.
This is
Yay.
One overdye.
Whoa. Really?
I know. Yes. And two overdyes. And
I
then,
love that color.
I know. And then...
Beautiful.
And then good old Joanne's, one of my favorites,
Yay.
Is inexpensive, and it's,
love.
I have her upside down. It is Premier Yarns, yeah, and it's called, it's Deborah Norville, Serenity Sock Yarn.
Serenity Sock.
And they had a huge sale, and you know what I paid for this?
At Joanne's?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, like 50 cents probably.
No, $2.49
well,
US
not
for
bad.
It. And it's lovely,
yeah.
Feel it.
Yeah,
it's nice.
Beautiful.
It knits up beautifully.
What is the content?
I don't know, you use your eyes.
Yeah,
my glasses on.
Merino, 50% merino.
Mm-hmm.
Unreal. Yeah. And
acrylic and nylon or something, right?
50% merino.
Mm-hmm.
And then it doesn't say what else. Rayon made from bamboo.
No.
25 rayon made from bamboo and 25 nylon. So I could handle this because
yeah,
I
nice.
Can't knit with acrylic.
And I have a whole bunch of that. I should share that with you.
And I like the...
yeah, it's got a halo.
Halo.
A little bit of a halo.
Yeah,
so anyway, this is nice. This is on 72. I'm doing big.
72 stitches.
Yeah,
on
I'm
one
a tight. I'm a
US?
Tight knitter. Yeah,
so
on,
am I.
Yeah, and you're on your high sharps.
Yeah.
With one end dulled that my husband did for
That's
me.
Genius. That is genius.
I'm going to tell that
they
story.
They are stabbing sticks. Please
These
do.
Are stabbing sticks, only mm-hmm. on one side. I
They're
love
dangerous.
The point
yeah.
to get in,
yeah.
but when I'm using my finger to take it off,
yeah.
it hurts.
It hurt.
I have band-aids.
I have injuries.
So I said, honey,
yeah.
could you just dull one end? And he's
yeah.
got a grinder out in the garage, and he just carefully ground off the one.
The one end that you push
So that
with.
When I have that, still have the nice sharp edge,
yeah.
and then the other side. But you got to be careful how you cast on. I've cast on before, and I'm going like,
oh,
I got it backwards.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
yeah.
You have to be careful
yeah.
how you
yeah.
cast it on.
Yeah,
yeah,
no, that is amazing.
So that's that.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's my... my
good.
Isn't that fun? I
it
love
so
And the
fun.
Colors together.
Oh my gosh, I love them.
I know, but they,
Those
that's
over,
another
that
thing,
over
too.
That overdye day was so fun.
These two are so close sometimes when they are variegating that I have a tough time. I've had to rip back because I've missed
yeah.
where the yarn colors
oh, wow.
change. So that's
yeah,
a one little one
that?
Little flaw.
That one that you gave me was sitting in the sun and I couldn't get over the color.
And
like,
so did
was
you bring it?
Just so gorgeous. No. Mm-hmm. On Instagram, maybe.
Is it a sock yarn?
yeah.
But
it's
more
sock.
Of a heavier.
Remember I said send me the
mm-hmm.
before picture
mm-hmm.
so I could post it? I don't think I ever did
it's
a
an opal.
Side, but...
It's an opal and it's a six ply, I think.
My goodness.
It's a little bit heavier than your average sock yarn.
Turned out really good.
Mm-hmm.
And then you said you'd like to overdye your sock blink
mm-hmm.
and just make something from that.
Yeah.
Go for it. Well, I'd love to see what you
okay.
come
sure.
up with.
It looks
with.
Like we have to do another dyeing episode.
I know, hey? It's so fun. I've been learning so much. It's awesome.
It's good.
Yeah.
So any more whips
so that's
there,
my,
girl?
That's my Helix socks. That's your Helix socks. Oh, my gosh. No, but I could talk about kids.
Okay.
Kids are fun.
Yeah?
The kids... Oh, I do have another whip. I picked up the sweater again.
Oh, good.
So I am starting on
Obviously, you didn't get to your brother for Christmas.
Right. No. It's not going to, that was not going to happen. I had to get
maybe
sleep.
Next Christmas.
Actually, I owe him big time because I found all my textbooks on Kijiji in Victoria. And I'm like, I texted him and he lives on the island and his wife was in Victoria. So she went, what a sweetheart. Thank you so much. If you're watching, Linda, oh my gosh, I owe you big time.
So the ones that you just took are coming up?
The ones that are coming up from a RT who took the classes all at TRU at Thompson River University. And oh my God, like I'm $150.
Wow.
For all the techs. Yep. 3 years of RT school. Oh my gosh. Wow. I do have another whip.
You're so prepared. Okay. While you're finding that, I'm going to see if I have another whip.
I cast on all the things. As I was done school, I was a knitting machine because I had all these ideas in my head and I had to get them out. These are Wendy D. Johnson. That is my kid's school.
Okay, we're going to put a pause on it so you can answer. Okay, so your kid's not dying. No, that was the school and everything's good.
No one's barfing.
Instantly. Oh no.
You get the phone call and it's like, oh, so-and-so just puked in the hallway. Oh no.
Really?
Yeah.
Does that happen?
Yeah.
Okay, well, you talk, but we're going to talk. I'm going to go get more tea. Can I get
you
more coffee?
Monsieur Trudeau, he is just a lifesaver. He cleans up barf every day. I could not do his job.
Trudeau?
Yeah.
The other Trudeau cleans up barf too. Do you want more coffee?
Yeah.
Are you good?
I'm good.
Are you good? I'm going to just quickly heat up.
Yeah.
You carry on and talk about what you're going to talk about, your kid thing. So let's talk about your giveaway.
Yes. So
you mentioned it on Instagram?
I mentioned it on Instagram. And the next time we got together, I was supposed to mention the sparkle skein with the Stellina, Merino Stellina, on my... Sandy Beach Park base.
So what is that? Is that a fingering or a...
It's a... Shoot. Gee. Shucks.
Is it a sock weight?
Look it up on Ravelry.
Is it a fingering?
No. It's a weightier weight.
Like a DK?
Yeah, like something like that.
Anyhow, with it is going to be some giveaways from Ginger Snapdat, who's a good friend of ours. Well, mine. I don't know if you've met her.
Yeah, I did. Okay. I did meet her, and she's a sweetheart.
Where did we meet her?
At the Calgary Fiber Shindig Festival.
Anyway, she provided this cute little bag for us. She's tells me this is the Alberta tartan.
That's beautiful.
So I thought it's kind of Christmassy.
Yeah.
And I thought we'd add it to your Stellina.
Yeah.
That you're going to put together.
Yeah. And we'll post a picture of the giveaway on Instagram. We'll post it here. Now, to win it, you must comment below in the comments and comment to us
what your New Year's resolution is.
Okay. Or if you make one.
Or if you've already had one and since it's the end of January.
And how that's going.
Or has it ended.
I want to know how that's going. Because, you know, how that goes.
I know. How that goes.
I've been running once since.
Oh, really?
And
was that your resolution?
Oh, I got stuck. I didn't really make the resolution because if I make them, then you break them.
And then you're really disappointed in yourself. So anyway, maybe just comment about resolutions, whether you have one, whether your feelings on it, but something about the new year.
Yeah.
Since this is our first.
Healthy and
all that good stuff.
So we'll post this giveaway. Comment below. And next time we film a podcast, we will use the random number generator to pick the winner and send it along.
Awesome. So when are we going to podcast next? Do we know?
We don't know. Just when we can. You're away so much. No. I was like, what'd you do? Quit your job? You've been in Palm Springs. You did the Tour de Palm Springs, which is awesome.
Yeah, it was fun.
So is that much like the Tour de France?
Oh, yeah. For us old farts. It was a 20. I know. See? Right?
Which is great. Right.
I'll put that picture in here. My husband and I rode together because he had the flu. Otherwise, he would have done I only did a 25 mile, which is...
Only?
Well, I normally... Like, he does 100 mile.
Like, does your butt get sore? Like, well, can you walk for a week?
That's why you wear the hoo-ha cream and it tingles.
Oh my goodness. I have no idea.
Yeah, and then you wear the padded shorts.
Okay.
And you put the... I had padded shorts. Actually, on this ride, I did not use the... it's called a female riding cream, but it's called hoo-ha cream.
Oh, really?
And it helps. For friction, for sure. Oh, but it wasn't long enough for me to use the, need that.
I would have shorts. Like a padded sheepskin bike seat thing made out of memory foam.
Actually, they say...
I would do.
They say the less seat you have, the better it is. It hurts for a while, but it's less friction. So you have less, problems. Mm. Smaller seat that's fit for your body, I guess.
So how would a banana seat come into play?
I'm not even going to go there.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Okay.
Enter
the draw below. Yes. Comment what all you're, that good stuff. Yeah. Comment awesome. About New Year's.
Awesome.
All right. How cold is it in Germany?
Oh, it can be. But it's that damp cold.
Ah.
You know what
so
I mean?
So it just chills you right through the bone, like Vancouver.
I want to say Amy or Emily or...
Mm-mm, not ringing the bell.
It's bugging me. You keep talking and I'll look it up.
So she says that she prefers the BFL or a real wool, like on her kids' feet. Uh-huh. Not real wool, but anything but the superwash merino. Because it doesn't seem to keep her kids' feet warm, like really warm, toasty.
Yeah.
And I can vouch for that because my sock blanks, when I crank them out, double knit.
A homespun house.
Homespun house. Yeah.
There you go.
I love her. When I crank out the sock blanks on my BFL, Abby had the socks on, the complete project, and her feet sweat in them. Like, they're soaked. So I don't know if they're too warm, but
I'm trying to find her name.
A homespun house. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I can't remember her name. She's in Molly.
Molly.
Molly from the Homespun House. Yeah. There you go.
Yeah.
I knew it was like Amy or one of those E.
Yeah.
So there, salt.
So I love watching her.
So what's this?
Knitting. On the sticks. Mm-hmm. And these are my Wendy D. Johnson.
Diagonal
lace socks.
Right.
Love the heels.
It's
so
a
I
free
just,
pattern too. Did
I
you
just
know?
Like
on her website.
Oh really?
Yes.
I did not know that because I
or
have
maybe
the
I,
book.
Yeah.
No, I don't think it is. Well, I've never seen it.
She's
for
got
free.
A website that's got a whole bunch of PDFs on it.
Oh, and, really?
On her blog.
Okay.
Yeah,
so. I love her so much. I love her construction. Mm-hmm. So she does a short row wrap and turns here. I do
is
German
toe up,
short
obviously.
Rows.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, start at the toe. I do German short rows. I do the gusset first, then the German short rows, and then there's no heel flap. You're knitting this as you go, and then you just keep going in the round.
Wow.
So it is, I just really like, there's an SSK and a Purl 2 together, and you're just like knitting, picking,
And you're doing two at a time on circs. I love two at a time on circs. Because
okay.
You could, no?
These little 9-inch sticks, my fingers go numb. I don't know why. Something in my wrist or whatever.
Right.
But my fingers go numb.
So
and I have to like shake it out.
Oh, really?
Like,
that's a common complaint.
Is it?
Yes.
Because you're so like.
Yeah, and I don't. And it's funny. I have the biggest. Look at these hands. These are like.
See.
Look at. Huge hands. Huge hands. And it's how I do it. I keep my hands up like so.
Wow.
And I don't. And these are all relaxed. And the only thing that's working is like my three little pinchers, I guess.
So I don't know
I can
about
knit
them.
Forever. I can knit all day on those.
But even Homespun House says she can't knit on them because she can't stretch her stitches around. But I can't see that because I've worked kid socks, adult socks, 66 stitches on here. And I don't know. She must be an extreme tight knitter or knitting with really... fine.
Or really,
I don't know.
Or maybe she's knitting on bamboo
but
ones.
But she can't stretch them around. I think she said the hiyas. And I was like, what? Because there's
I find them really easy.
They're totally stretched around.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe hers were, I don't know.
So are you going to finish? You're not going to, how are you going to knit your socks now? You were a 9-inch circ girl.
Yeah, so I start them two at a time. And another podcaster was saying she hates two at a time because it takes her so long to.
I agree.
To do them. She's like, I can't, I just, there's no love there. Mm-hmm. So she's not going to do them. She's Yarngasm podcast. Kristen, love her. Love watching her. Mm. She's so inspiring. inspiring. And
I haven't watched her.
Oh, the sewing. Oh,
really?
You need to.
Okay.
Yeah. And then you inspired me to watch the mom and daughter.
Knit 24, Chelsea and Sue. The Legacy Podcast.
Legacy Podcast. So yeah, I watched them as well and love them to pieces.
Me too.
But yeah, so I'm going to continue on with these, but I think I might go to either two circs or just put one at a time on my magic loops.
Mm-hmm.
But Kristen should, here's an idea for her, if she watched, but I doubt she will. But anyways, she should just like cast on both at a time, mm-hmm. toe up,
mm-hmm.
and then work two simultaneously.
That's what I do. And
you know
why
I
do that? Because I forget what I do. Because there's sometimes you go, oh, I should make a note of that.
That too. Or, and she says, second sock syndrome is real,
mm-hmm.
people. It really exists.
You know, there's a real fashion thing going now where people wear totally different socks.
Oh,
so that would be fun. Why don't you do like, you know, you could do like Salt and Pepper, or you could do like like Scooby-Doo and Scrappy-Doo or something, you know, and it wouldn't be second sock.
You just knit one.
Yeah, you just knit
one. She calls them hoes, half objects.
I've heard that before.
So fun, right?
Yeah.
So fun. What else do you have on sticks?
I have another pair. Anytime they last me more than a couple months, I call them forever socks.
Oh.
I've been knitting these since August when I was on my trip with
my
husband.
Sometimes it's that way.
This is one.
This is gorgeous.
This is the Susan B. Anderson smooth operator socks.
Yes.
I finished the one.
Yeah.
I have made progress, but
how do you like that heel? Is that cool?
It's good, but she did an update to get rid of the little gap.
Oh,
I have a gap,
okay.
So I'll have to go in with my ends and kind of close the hole.
Which is doable.
Yeah. And so this is, I've finally got the waist yarn in for the heel.
Yay.
So I've gotten to this point here.
Okay. So that's an afterthought kind of heel.
And then you knit down another couple inches, and then you put in the afterthought before you're done.
Do you like that heel?
Yeah, it's not bad.
Yeah,
the way she you do three rows of the waist yarn so that you can pick it out quite easily.
Okay.
And then you put it on your needle. But I like it because she has you go to here and put the heel in, and then you can make it fit you because you can try it on.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
So
I like finishing as I go.
Do you?
Yeah. I didn't talk about my FO, the one I'm wearing, In Stillness.
Is this new?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, this is my In Stillness.
Mm. And what yarn is this?
And this is my Riley Park base, worsted weight base, hand-dyed by me, and I just love how the variation turned out. I actually alternated skeins.
Nice.
I could have done a little bit more length, but I like having
your shirt,
you know,
hang out
my
the bottom.
Shirt hang mm-hmm. out and, mm-hmm. and just a little bit of contrast. But there's a little bit of pooling in here I can see.
Yeah, that's okay,
because
though.
I quit alternating. I got lazy at the end and just wanted to finish. But I love it. And I finished it as I went. A lot of people complain about this pattern because there's a few things that are just a little like out of place or whatever. Mm-hmm. Just tricky to
who's a designer
to figure out. So that is Wendy. No,
not her.
Oh, gosh. Ah, okay. We'll.
Is
put it
like
Hannah? We'll put it in. No.
Carrie Bostico.
That's my next one, though.
I know.
Hannah Fettig.
I know.
Oh my gosh.
And Carrie Bostico.
I ordered some fingering single ply, which I'm gonna dye up and totally do like a solid colorway and then a speckled colorway and
what pattern are you
knit
gonna
that
do?
Up.
Is it a cardigan or a pullover?
I think I even added it to my cast-ons.
Mm-hmm.
Like, gotta go.
She's been all over, like, social media recently because she's got a new book out.
Oh, who?
Hannah Fettig.
Really?
Yes.
I did not
know. I think
it's
called Texture.
No way.
Yeah.
Sweet Georgia Yarn just got a book out.
Mm-hmm.
Dying to Spin, or I think. And I listened to some podcast on that, and it was really, really good. She's got some great dye pictures and a lot of info on color.
Oh, cool. And this is in a book or is it on a website?
It's in a book. Okay. She wrote it.
Oh,
and,
cool. And this is
her new
Sweet
book.
Georgia?
Sweet Georgia.
Okay.
Her new book,
cool.
Which is awesome. I'm just looking up the next, my next sweater. because I just have to knit all the sweaters. Like,
I still need to finish this one. I've got the Lila by
Carrie
Bostic.
Well, we're waiting.
Okay, sure. I'll show it, but I haven't done anything on it. It's kind of on at a standstill.
And How come?
I don't know. I just can't seem to like get it going.
That is so funny. I cast on a sweater, and I have an easier time finishing sweaters than I do socks.
Oh, really?
Because socks seem to take forever.
I can't seem to find my sweater. I had it out.
You had it.
I don't remember what the bag looked like. That's how long it's been since I did it. Anyway, it's the Lila sweater, and it's in swish. Where did I put that bag? Oh, here it is. Found it.
Okay, I was going to say it's...
I'm using Knit-Nix, and it's lovely. It's squishy and lovely.
Please show your bag.
I've showed this before.
So gorgeous.
It's fun.
I love it.
It's the donut. It's by you so-and-so. Anyway, it's really cute. I'm using this.
Which feels heavenly.
It is. It really is. It's 100% superwash merino.
Yeah, it's nice.
And I'm finished all my German short rows. I'd never done them before. But yeah, what I like about this, and it's a pattern that, you know how you talk about it being short? This one is short in the front, and then it scoops down in the back,
longer
right?
Longer in the back. I love it.
Yeah, see, that's the back. Oh, it's longer. Look how wrinkly I just
showed. How many sweaters have you knit?
Seriously?
A few? Or is this your... Okay.
One for my infant brand new baby grandson.
Oh, yes. That was your
first? Then one.
Wow.
I know. And then one for my cousin's new grandson. So okay. I've only done little sweaters. I've never actually knit a full-on
sweater.
Big sweater. So
I just can't get enough of them.
But they're lovely.
Nothing like waking up in the morning.
But I kind of got off. I can't remember where I left off in the pattern, and it wasn't taking me half an hour to, you know, it's not something I can just quickly pick up. So I will get to it. And the other thing that I haven't gotten to, and I promised her, is my German friend with her shawl.
Yes, with her shawl.
I know, and
translating.
I know, translating.
Right?
I know, and I haven't done that, and I need to do that. I'm sorry, Lisa. I'll get to that too. So. Those are that's my pile of shame over there.
I can't get my phone to work. I don't know why. It's roaming. Like, come on. Don't do that.
Okay.
Okay, so, wasn't meant to happen, but it's on my Ravelry. So this
one teeny tiny bag.
Yeah, I made it. It's so bad.
A hat.
So this is a
surprise!
Hat.
Surprise!
Another hat!
Surprise!
Right? What kind of knitter are you? Put it in the comments below. I am a hat knitter, apparently.
Big time.
This is my hand-dyed yarn in our sport weight base.
Is that the one for your friend?
Love, love, love it. This is,
that you started...
but it's like so late. I got messed up in my cables. Oh. I'm almost ready to reduce, but this is the Adiantum by Woolly Wormhead.
Really
so
cute.
That's it there. Mm-hmm. I can't wait. I need to just finish
that. And that's
that.
For your friend.
That is for my friend who I just kind
Some
of
Some friend you are.
I know. But I haven't even told her I was knitting it, so she doesn't even know. And I won't.
I want to talk about one more thing before you. It looks like you've got all kinds of fun things about kids, but I just want to mention one thing. I've become a spinner, right?
Yeah.
And I showed, last podcast, I showed my basket. That I
and your
finished.
Spinning wheel? Did you even show that off? I haven't
I did
seen it.
Well, on my last podcast that you might not have watched. It was one I did solo just before Christmas.
I thought okay.
And
I did watch it.
It was a basket I had hanging out over there.
Okay.
Anyhow.
Remind me, yeah.
I have a friend who's a farmer, and he has sourced me a fleece.
Yay.
But guess what he sourced me?
What? Alpaca.
No. Related to the alpaca. A llama.
Oh. Wow.
I've been doing some reading
about it. Tell me about it.
It's got two coats.
Oh.
It's got an outer coat that's got like almost whiskery hair.
Wow.
And then it's got an undercoat, which is soft and beautiful.
Oh my goodness.
So it might take
some
work.
So is that guard hair?
Yes.
Is that the guard hair
mm-hmm.
that they talk about?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So I'm going to have to either not worry about it, but I hear the guard hair doesn't spin well. So I might have, I don't know what, I'm still reading on Pinterest. On Pinterest, I've got a new kind of a, what do you call it, a clipboard or no? Corkboard. The board.
Okay.
I have a new board called From Fleece to Fiber.
Oh.
And I've been doing a lot of reading on there.
Oh.
And the Yarn Harlot.
Yes.
Has this awesome, really great way that she washes the yarn and prepares
it.
She puts it, she wraps it, and then washes it inside out.
I bought a book on fleece.
Oh, did you?
And I should have brought it.
You should have. But I'd like to borrow it from you.
And it is unreal. Anyway. It goes through every single animal.
I'm going to place the picture in here. He sent me a picture of the fleece.
Okay.
But it looks, my sister goes, is it skinned?
Oh, what my he did, goodness.
What he did is the guy shaved the llama
and just left
it in a blanket.
Yeah.
Rolled the blanket up.
Yeah.
So it looks like it's like on a hide and then pulled out a little of the color. And it's a beautiful, it's kind of the, it's a lighter of this caramel.
Oh, wow.
That's, at least
natural
that's what
color of the animal.
I don't have to dye it at all. I have to wash it.
Amazing.
And then card it.
Oh,
and spin it.
Oh, my goodness. I know. So you're like,
I know.
Really? You're the real deal.
I'm trying to be.
It's my dream. I want a wheel so bad.
Well, do you want to come over and wash fleece with
I
me?
I would love to.
When it comes, when the little fleece comes, you can come over. So it might have a lot of barnyard in it. I don't know.
Probably. Yeah. You can get, you can make like
a blower? Have you seen that?
Yes.
Where you put it all in a cage?
In a cage.
And
the
blow
guy
it?
Blows it.
Yeah,
I watched
that
on YouTube. That's hilarious. I'm a YouTube addict. What else? There's a lady who just put it on a 4x4, like little tiny square grids, mm-hmm. like little tiny squares, mm-hmm. so the fleece doesn't fall through. And then, you can do the same thing with a leaf blower mm-hmm. and blow it. I have a funny story about that when I was landscaping. Mm-hmm. So the name of my company was Jungle Jane's Tree and Lawn Experts. And
she's done everything.
I was a horticulturalist, like a little bit of a tree climber. And I've done, everything. Jack of all trades.
Uh-huh.
And so I
master
finished. Yeah, exactly. I think I'm a master knitter. I don't know. They say it takes 10,000 hours to... become really good at something. My girlfriend's son is doing lacrosse and he is like so
obsessed
sweet
with it.
And so obsessed and so wants to be good. And he's like, Mom, I need to do my hour today mm-hmm. and my hour. He's got it all planned so he can get in his 10,000 hours and become an expert at the. So
there's
I'm
a
like,
book about that.
I said to Leanne, I think we're expert knitters. We must be expert knitters by now because I'm sure we've got 10,000 hours.
You can take the knitting course to become a certified knitter or whatever.
Oh, really?
Yeah, through Olds.
Yeah, well, I'd like to do the spinning one and become a master spinner.
I really
want to take spinning. So if you want to do a spin class, I looked up some Heritage Park.
I saw that too.
Stuff like that. So let's do a beginner spinner because then you won't leave me behind.
No.
I'll be able to keep up. But the funny about the leaf blower. So this little boy is following me around. His dad hired me to do a fall cleanup. And I got out my leaf blower, my backpack blower, and I'm just blowing all the grass out of the flower beds and onto the lawn so I can rake it up. And he starts freaking out when I start up the leaf blower and he's chasing me around the yard and he's like, blow me, blow me. And he's like, Dad, come get a blow. And his dad's sitting on the deck and his dad's like, wow, yeah, okay. Like, you have no idea what you just said, kid, but that was not good. I just like started peeing my pants laughing so bad. So that story has come, like, it's been followed me around. And
there you go.
Everyone's like, tell the leaf blower story about that little kid. He must have been about 5 years old and he was so excited because I grabbed the leaf blower and I gave him a shot in the face and all his hair was like, you know, and he got a good one, right? He's like, Dad, come get a blow. Oh my God. So funny. Yeah. So
let's move on to kids.
So on to kids.
Speaking of kids.
Kids are so funny. My kids have been totally into doing this nail art. So we've got hammers and wood, like my husband frames houses. So, you know, we just go and raid all the cutoffs and they are like, so you just print out a picture and then you use the little nails and tack it in. So this is the little sheep that Isabel made me. I'm so excited about that.
That is so cute.
And it's so fun for them. So for your kids at school.
Yeah, that's really cute. You can totally tell it's a sheep.
Totally. Mm-hmm. It's awesome. So that's been fun. And what else have we been doing? We've been making pom-poms. They're crazy about that. So, you know, my kids were off quite some time at Christmas.
I know, I'm a teacher.
That was large at the same system. So, you know. I was like, oh my goodness, they're going stir crazy. So we went and spent about 3 hours at Michael's one day. And my daughter saw this on some crazy podcaster on YouTube. And she talked about the so many treats. Well, it took us forever to find. But she, her and Abby take sewing, and you should see what they're making. Like, my little one is amazing. So is Isabel, but so Isabel made me a pair.
That is so cute.
And I love her. She's so sweet. Mm. And she does such a good job. And so she sits there for hours just sewing little.
Aww.
Yeah.
So you just get felt? All you need is felt
and
stuffing?
So it comes all together. It comes with the whole. So if you have an 11-year-old girl at home, or boy, my boy is totally into it too. Mm-hmm. It comes with all the stuff. She's made pretty much all the things. The bacon.
Really?
Yeah, the eggs.
Where's the bacon?
It's hilarious. It's Aww. Awesome. It is so cute. So
that is really
she's
cute.
Made the toaster pastry.
Aw.
Yeah, it's so fun. And then so she came home with a list. Because all the kids
at
school.
Oh, I want this.
So she's got a list of who wants what and what they want on it. And do they want sprinkles on their donut? And yes, I want sprinkles. Do you want a happy face or a sad face or a frown face?
So cute.
So yeah, they've been a lot of fun. So yeah.
Okay, I see cupcakes.
Oh, you do. This is your choice of Christmas presents. This is fun. I have been so busy. Actually, I've been so busy knitting, I haven't had a chance to post
Look
any of this
that.
On my site.
Is that you're making kits? Is
these
that
are my, yeah. Kits? So I got some packaging because I've been playing around with some packaging.
Aww.
And so I've been making some cupcakes.
Are these on your website?
So this is your choice. They're not because I'm so bad. Like, I haven't even had time to post it. I'm just a yarn hoarder. I don't actually put it on my site. I will. I'm having to do an update today because I've got people bugging me about it.
Really?
On the spice market, shawl kits. So I'm going to update that. I've been winding yarn like crazy, getting them all caked up and ready to go.
People want them? They're trying to?
Yeah, they're trying to, yeah. And they're all sold out on my site. So I just need to do some updates.
That's really nice.
But these are my little new packages. And I have had so much fun doing these. So these are my triplets. These are all my carbon.
See, that would be fun to do a helix with that. But you know what? I would be...
There's
so
these
lost.
Guys. There's these.
Oh, that's cool.
Like, so you get to pick your choice.
Oh my goodness.
I just didn't want to pick for you because I don't know what you're all about color wise.
You should pick for me.
And then what else? Oh, and then I've got the doubles. So there are two in there.
Nice.
So yeah, I just have to do
So how many grams would these be? I should get my little scale out and we'll measure.
Yeah. Oh, these are all I do know.
30?
Yeah.
So there's
we talked about
grams.
This before. So this is the Carburn Park. I don't know if you can see that.
It's backwards.
Backwards.
But it turns out, you know that, eh?
Oh, does it?
Yeah, because one of the very first episodes of The Grocery Girls,
they
were laughing. It's backwards. Oh my gosh, we'll have
but
to fix it.
But it did
and then it
come out.
Yeah.
That's weird, hey? That is so weird. It's like the ambulance in the mirror. They write it backwards and then it comes out right.
When you look in your review.
So 30 grams.
Yeah.
There's approximately 100 yards in each skein, so.
So what's really cool, if you had three delicious. Of your minis, of your sock
Those are
yarn.
Pretty awesome.
Then you could make a pair of socks because you can definitely make a pair of socks out of 30 gram. That's
okay.
90 grams.
That's
absolutely. Yeah. You would absolutely be able to.
So
make
So the
a pair
helix
of
socks.
Socks
will be good for that.
That you maybe should have helix sock kits with your new pattern.
I should. Yeah.
How cool would that be?
I know. I need.
And they
to
can
be
mix or match their own
me.
Colors. Yes, we should.
Yeah, I need to clone myself.
Oh, well, you know what? How long have we been yakking? A long time.
Yeah,
I want to be
time.
Under an hour.
Yeah,
so I think we're about 45 minutes.
We're good.
So that's good.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
We should probably say today's date. Do you know it?
No.
It's Monday.
It's Monday.
January.
January 30th.
Is it?
Yeah.
Really?
We have clouds and sun today.
Yeah.
It's 1 degree Celsius it's in Calgary, mm-hmm. Alberta, Canada.
But it's supposed to get lousy later.
It's sunny and beautiful. Mm-hmm. It was lousy last night. My husband was out smoking
ribs
on the deck last night, and he was trying to do deep fry chicken wings, and he said it got so cold that the deep fryer just totally lost all its heat.
Oh, wow.
And he couldn't the second batch. It was just, yeah, the wind, and it got cold. But it's gorgeous out today.
It's lovely. We're having a little bit of melting out there.
Which is so nice about Calgary. If you live in Edmonton, you don't get the Chinooks that Calgary does. And so I'm really fortunate for that. I did go to college there for a little bit. Yeah.
We have a business running out of Edmonton. So we go up.
Oh.
And our grandson's there.
Oh, yeah. That's right. Hey. Yeah. So.
Well,
thanks for joining us.
That was
my
fun.
Gosh.
A lot of catching up. It was good.
Yeah, it was good.
Till next time. See you later.
Bye.